a robust department of surgery requires that you accomplish everything. And everything includes being great educators, it includes being fabulous researchers, and probably most important, it requires that you be really fabulous surgeons, great technically and able to take excellent care of patients. And at UW, in our Department of Surgery, we really are great at all three. The National Institute of Health ranks departments of surgery around the country. There are 250-some academic surgical departments in the country. In the last 2 years, related to some really great advancements from some of our existing surgeons and recruitment of new surgeons, we've now moved to the top 10 programs in the country in terms of our NIH funding, which again, I think is an extraordinary indicator of our research potential. Once into the top 10, how do we move into the top 5, or how do we move into the top 3, or maybe second in the country? The way we do that is by enabling these really fabulous surgeons that we have to be able to make even more discoveries.
The great thing about the department is you have individuals here that not only do the most up-to-date, high-level, cutting-edge surgical clinical care, doing outstanding operations, but those surgeons also recognize the limitations of the technology that exists today, the treatments, so they can identify the problem. And because we have such outstanding research here, we take that identified problem back to the laboratory, and the goal would be to solve that problem and then to take it back from the bed to the bench side, and from the bench side back to the bed, where we could actually fix that initial problem we identified.
As a clinician, you're in a really unique position to understand translational science, because you know what needs to be done with the patient, and if you do some basic science, you also understand what needs to be done at the bench.
So I study voice. The University of Wisconsin-Madison has a reputation and history of being one of the largest and best voice centers in the country. We can advance the science faster than other places because we aren't working alone.
Well, the excitement I see in the lab every day is to see a whole bunch of young people that are interested in advancing science and advancing the care of patients. So we really have the capacity here not only to affect the care of patients here in the region or in Wisconsin, but we have the impact to affect care that's going to be delivered in China, Australia, all over the world based on the experiences that these individuals have here.
There are a lot of very important issues in ethics in surgery, things like informed consent, end-of-life issues, things about disclosure of unanticipated outcomes to patients, and of course transplant ethics, where there are resources that are scarce and you need to figure out how to divide those resources amongst a very small group of people. My ultimate goal with this research is to make sure that we can respect patient preferences after an operation, particularly in the setting of an outcome that was unanticipated.
Everybody in healthcare wants to have the best outcome they can for patients. I think that the University of Wisconsin is very uniquely positioned to lead the country and really the international community in terms of improving patient safety. And so there's a lot of very innovative national programs going on to help try to provide feedback on performance to physicians. By getting that feedback, they're going to be able to improve their performance and make surgery safer, more efficient, and more effective.
Education is part of every faculty member's responsibility. I mean, the ability to help shape the next generation of care providers, whether it's physicians that are going to be surgeons, primary care physicians, or subspecialty physicians is truly a privilege. Probably the most excitement in terms of reliving why any of us chose to be a physician occurs with our interactions with the medical students. When you see them light up with some concept you've taught or show them a physical exam finding that they've only been reading about. Education starts here, but really extends through most of the continents in the world. And that sounds broad, but that's actually true.
So the reason why, we care about global education is not only just because we are compassionate, but because, again, the world is really small. You can find yourself outside and away from home. very easily. You can find people come here from elsewhere, and you need to know about what kind of diseases happen there. One of the, I think, the misconceptions is always that with global health, we think we only help people. But that's not true. Actually, most volunteers who go and serve and come back always say that they learned more than they thought. So it's ultimately going to be beneficial for us as well.
Well, we hope one day, shortly, right around the corner, we're able to help many, many people with their diabetes. The whole purpose of either a pancreas transplant or an islet transplant is so people completely eliminate the need to take any insulin at all. And it's as though they were never diabetic.
I'm proud of all the research. I'm proud of our great educators. I'm proud of the very fabulous surgery that we're able to perform. But I'm most proud of the surgeons and the people that help the surgeons, because they're just really great people. Medicine evolves, it continues to evolve. UW's Department of Surgery has been at the forefront of that evolution. We want to stay there. So the great research now is being conducted in centers where people are able to collaborate, where there are many bright researchers. And University of Wisconsin clearly is one of those places. We have a great medical school, we have a great Department of Surgery, but it's really the overall great university that allows the collaborations that make us so successful.